Yes. Hi, Dr. Klein.
Hi.
I have a couple questions. I've had two blood tests, thyroid tests, and only because I guess I'm becoming an internet doctor.
Okay. Fair enough.
You know, both of them are all in range. I think one was, the total thyroid was 2.9, another one was 2.7. TSH, T3, and T4 were all in range.
All right.
But when I get up in the morning, my body temperature's like 97.2, 97.4.
All right.
I haven't lost weight. I'm not tired, but, you know, I've been reading.
All right, we need to read more. All right, so JT, what's your temperature look like, oh, let's say by noon? How hot are you getting?
Oh, maybe 98, maybe 97, 8, somewhere around there.
All right. Well, for starters, doing a T3, T4, T uptake, a TSH really is doing a kind of a halfway job, okay? Because really what you need to be checking on top of that is thyroid peroxidase and antithyroglobulins. Now, why? Because what will happen is you could have autoimmune thyroid disease and the indices are all normal. Okay, it's like having a pocket full of keys. You can have enough keys, but if they're bent, they don't work. Okay, so now you know, or at least your pituitary thinks you have enough keys, but you don't know that they're effective. The second thing is that if your testosterone level is inadequate, it can cause what you would call euthyroid sick. So there are other things that need to be checked. Does that make sense? So if you're going to be an internet doc, you have to go to graduate level on this one and look for other things that cause the TSH to not be stimulated, like estrogen. Okay? So if your estrogen level's too high, it'll suppress your TSH. So there are lots of things that can cause this picture, okay? But it's not necessarily one hormone, one effect. So let's send you back to class on that one, my friend. And what we'll do is we'll go ahead and take the next call.